Nagsimula na ang registration para sa biggest at isa sa longest running marathon sa bansa, ang National Milo Marathon. Sa Urdaneta, Pangasinan, gaganapin ang unang karera at tatawid din sa iba't ibang bahagi ng bansa ang iba pang races ng National Milo Marathon na tatagal hanggang December ngayong taon. And to tell us more about this, kasama natin si Lester Castillo. Siya ang AVP at Milo Sports Manager ng Nestle Philippines at andito din ang President ng Philippine Athletics Track and Field Association na si Philip Ella Juico. At syempre si Edward Kho, ang Special Projects Director ng PATAFA. Mga sir, magandang gabi po and welcome to the score.
Good evening, Anton.
Good evening. So, Sir Lester, I will start with you since we're talking about Milo again and we have the 2018 National Milo Marathon. Can you tell everybody about this project?
Okay, so this year, we have the same powerful message as last year. Mm-hmm. Our theme is magsama-sama, tumakbo at matuto. Matuto ng mga life values that can help these children succeed later on in life. Ano itong mga values na to? These are disiplina, kumpiyansa, at saka pakikisama. So this year, we have a total of 11 races for the National wow. Milo Marathon. Nationwide ito, ang finals natin ay mangyayari sa Lawag on December 9. As you mentioned earlier, it will kick off in Urdaneta on July 15. And then ang second race natin is July 29 sa Manila. So we have a total of 5 different categories, 3, 5, 10, 21, and 42K. So hopefully we get to attract a lot of participants to join this race and learn the different character forming values that come with it.
All right, and we also have the president of PATAFA, Sir Philip Ella Juico. Sir Philip, I want to ask you, what value does the National Milo Marathon give to Philippine athletics?
Well, a lot of value because the Milo Marathon is well publicized. It raises the profile of not just marathon, but athletics in general, which is our aim. And it promotes the same values that we want to promote. It's the same values that you need for nation building. Discipline, respect for authority, respect for law and order. All of those things that that are needed to become a good citizen, especially the discipline part, no? And then trying to test your threshold. Hanggang saan ka pwedeng umabot, no? Mm-hmm. And those are the things we want to see in our athletes. And as I said, they help us. They're our partners in promoting sports and promoting good values.
Okay. Now I want to talk to the project director of PATAFA, Sir Edward Kho. Sir Edward, sinabi nga ni Sir Lester, we're going to have 11 races. Now what does it mean when PATAFA sanctions these races held by Milo and Nestle Philippines?
For one, any performance that surpasses an existing national record, let's say 21K or marathon, gets to be recognized as a new national record. Because without the sanction of PATAFA, it wouldn't be taken in the books. Mm-hmm. And then another thing is that the value that's given to Milo as a brand is that PATAFA gets to be one of its sort of like an evaluator or auditor to make sure that the brand of the implementation of the races across all legs will be the same standard.
All right. Going back to Sir Lester, of course, when we talk about the National Milo Marathon, there's going to be some winners. There's going to be a king and the queen for this year's event. What's in store for the king and queen of the National Milo Marathon this year?
So the 2017 king and queen in the form of George Andrade all the way from Davao, and the five-time National Milo Marathon queen and former Olympian Mary Joy Tabol of Cebu, yes, will be defending their NMM king and queen titles this year. So anong makukuha ng king and queen natin this year? Actually, there are three items. So number one, of course, they will take home a huge cash prize together with the trophy. They will also be given an exposure to an international trip. And together with our official timekeeper, Tag Heuer, both of them will receive a Tag Heuer of their own to immortalize that feat of being a champion of that race.
Wow.
And of course, one of the biggest news that we have in store for the King and Queen this year is their participation in the 2019 SEA Games.
Wow.
But I'd let Sir Philip talk about it in more detail.
Yeah, yes, sir. It's obviously something na inaabangan ng mga Pilipino, yung 2019 SEA Games. So can you tell us about the opportunity for the king and queen of the National Milo Marathon when they get a chance to represent the Philippines next year?
Well, since the Milo Marathon is sanctioned by PATAFA, we use it as the qualifier for the SEA Games, the tryout. And we're allowed to field, each country is allowed, or I think the case of the Philippines is we're the host, we're allowed to enter three athletes per category, men and women. And we figured that, we talked with Milo and we said, why don't we schedule the races in such a way that we will not have him burn out, because it's not good for athletes to be racing more than two or three marathons per year. So we said, you have your Milo Marathon in December 2018, we have the SEA Games in 2019, November, so in between they can avail themselves of the prize, and we recommended a half marathon so that they can do the marathon but not be burned out, so they can still retain their competitive edge, 21 kilometers marathon in Seoul, Korea.
All right, nice. So you mentioned Seoul, Korea. There will be some international races. Can you tell us more about this, Sir Edward?
Based on recent arrangements with our counterpart federations, specifically Korean Athletics Federation, they've been constantly inviting us year in, every year, with their Incheon International Half Marathon. So that's one of the options that we have for the eventual Milo Marathon King and Queen. And then there are other IAAF, our mother international federation, which could be also one of the venues for the eventual winners of Milo Marathon, where they could participate as legitimate entries for the Philippines.
All right. So I think we're all set. Sir Lester, kindly invite everybody watching right now to join and give them more information about the National Milo Marathon.
Okay, so we'd like to invite everyone to join the 42nd National Milo Marathon. We have a total of five categories. It's a 3K, 5K, 10K, 21K, and 42K. If you want to know more details, please visit our website, www.milo.com.ph.
All right. Thank you very much, Sir Lester, Sir Philip, and Sir Edward. Good evening po sa inyo. Maraming salamat.
Thank you, Anton.
For more sports updates, keep watching The Score. And don't forget to subscribe.